Alright, guys, I'm sorry about this. I just have a problem network here. Just to explain this again, we're still in this example. We want to find the integral of this function. Okay, from 0 to 1 over 6 sine inverse of 3x dx. This is a definite integral. So definite integral have these numbers here. This is the values of x. We call them the limits. We integrate this function from when x is 0 to 1 over 6. So when we have indefinite integral, you consider these numbers, these limits, we call them limits of x at the end of your integration. Yeah? So the first step is just integrating this function you want to integrate, sine inverse of 3x dx first. Okay, so we take the integral first, we're going to consider the limits after we integrate our function. Eh? So when we're integrating sine inverse of 3x, always when you're integrating inverse function, you use integration by parts. Eh? So that's why I write my integration by parts formula. And then we let u to be the function that we want to integrate. It's either an inverse function or it's a log function. So we use just integration by parts by choosing u to be that function that we want to integrate. Eh? So my function that we want to integrate is sine inverse of 3x. So let u to be sine inverse of 3x. And then dv from my formula, it should be just dx. Just no dv go dx. And then from u, find du. I'll use the formula for sine inverse. Okay, this formula for sine inverse. Derivative of sine inverse of x. It's 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. Eh? And this formula will always going to be given if I know you want to use them. So now we use this formula to evaluate the derivative of 3 sine inverse of 3x. Eh? Since we have an inner function instead of x, we have 3x. So we know we're going to apply a chain rule. Eh? We're going to start by using the formula where there's x, I will substitute 3x. Eh? So the derivative of sine inverse of 3x would be where there's x is 1 over 1. I put 3x all squared. So that's why we have 9x squared. Eh? Because we have an inner function, which is 3x, we need to multiply by the derivative of the inner function, which is 3. Okay. So since it's du, again, du go with dx. Eh? We put dx here. So from u, basically, we're finding the derivative of this function, which is 3 over square root of 1 minus 9x squared, and then dx. And then from dv, we find v. It's just the integral of this. The integral of dx is x. Okay. After you're finding u and dv and du and v, you're ready to use your integral by parts formula. Okay. So we take what we want to integrate here. We want to integrate sine inverse of 3x dx. Since we said this is u and this is v dv, so it now follow integration by parts formula. I just rewrite this formula here, so I will not make a mistake because I know now I want to substitute everything here into my formula, right? So we start with u first term. My first term, it's u times v. This is u multiplied by v, okay. It's x times sine inverse of 3x, minus v, and then if I check v, my v is x, I substitute x here. And it's multiplied by du, you see what is du? This is du, is 3 over square root of 1 minus 9x squared and dx. So in the next step was to integrate the second term. I started by simplifying. I return my first term. And then take 3 out here. This is 3. So ignore this minus 18 over 18 here for now. So I return this x here, and then I rewrite this as in the numerator. So it will be to the power of minus half. So this one minus 9x squared, which is to the power of half in the denominator. If I take it to the numerator, it will be to the power of minus half. And then we have this dx. So here I see I have a function that is to the power of, I want to integrate a function that is to the power of n. So I can use this formula from math one. Want to integrate the second term. This formula from math one say if you're integrating a function that is to the power of n, and this function have its derivative here, you can just use this formula and just integrate and say your integral is f of x to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c. You see, after integrating, you don't have f prime. So what you need to do is to check your f of x if it's a derivative here. You let your f of x to be a function that is to the power of n. That's why we take this as f of x. We take as f of x. Now we need to check if it's we have f prime. We want to check if we have this form. So I check a derivative of this. I find the derivative of this is minus 18x. Okay, when I'm deriving this. When I check here, I only had x. I said ignore this minus 18. I only had x, but my derivative is minus 18x. So I'm short with minus 18. That's why I introduced this minus 18. Minus 18, it's a constant. So with the constant, you can always do anything with the constant. You can pull out the constant as we did. We pull out this 3 here. So now we need the constant. You can always introduce the constant that you, if you need that. So we introduce minus 18. But when you introduce minus 18, we need also to divide it by minus 18. Because minus 18 divided by minus 18, it's 1. It's like we didn't affect the value of this integral. But the nice thing, we have this form now. We have f prime f of x to the power of n. You see the derivative of what is inside here, it's outside here. Okay. We have f prime f of x to the power of n. So now we can able to integrate this using this formula. All right. The integral will be just f of x to the power of n plus 1 over n plus 1. Okay. Let's do that. Okay. So yeah, we wanted to integrate the second term. Okay. So the integral of this is just, let's return the first term. And this negative term is just a plus 1 over 6, okay? And the integral of this will be f of x according to this formula. You see the integral should be f of x to the power of n plus 1, eh? So our f of x here is 1 minus 9x squared to the power of n plus 1. So minus half plus 1 is half divided by half. When we divide it by fraction, it's same with multiplying by. So instead of dividing by a fraction, you can just multiply by its reciprocal, like 2 over 1. Yeah? So multiply by 2 over 1. And then you set plus c. This is your final answer. Okay. Right. So this is the integral. This is the integral of a sine inverse of 3x. We use integration by parts. Happening now. We have sine here inverse, okay? This is my integral. Remember, we wanted to find the integral from 0 to 1 over 6. I said, first always start by integrating your function. This is the integral of your function. We use integration by parts because we know when we're integrating inverse function, we use integration by parts. So now let's evaluate our question. So we want to evaluate the integral from 0 to 1 over 6. You see now, let's consider these numbers. Okay. Let's do that. How we use these numbers. So the integral. Integral from 0 to 1 over 6 of sine inverse of 3x dx. It's going to be the integral of this function. The integral of this function, we just found it here. You see, the integral of sine inverse of 3x is this one. It's going to be this integral, which is, let's write it, x sine 3x plus 1 over 3, 1 minus 9 x squared to the power of half. Because now we have these limits, so instead of saying plus c, we're just going to write our limits like this from 0 to 118, 0 to 1 over 3, sorry. 1 over 6. When we have these limits, you don't need plus c after integrating here. You just write your limits like this. We want this definite integral. This definite integral needs the integral of this function. This is the one that we found with the integration by parts. So now we consider these limits now. Once we have limits like this, so instead of saying plus c, write them like this, which means you're ready now to evaluate them. How to evaluate those limits? You start with the upper limit. We call this the upper limit, and this is the lower limit. You start with the upper limit, substitute away this x, this upper limit. We substituting 1 over 6 sine inverse. If you substitute 1 over 6, it will be 3 over 6, sine inverse of 1 over 2 plus 1 over 3, 1 minus 9. If you put 1 over 6 all squared, it's 1 over 36, to the power of half. Okay, we're starting by substituting the upper limit, and that's how we substitute the upper limit here. Where there's x, we just substitute the upper limit. And then you say minus, always open a bracket, and substitute the lower limit. Lower limit is 0, so when you substitute 0, the first term will be 0, plus, substitute 0 here, so it will be, this will be 0, so 1 to the half is 1, so it's 1 over 3. So next step, you can just put everything into your calculator. You can use your this sine inverse. You can check with the calculator to make sure your calculator is in radians. You're no longer working with degrees there, so make sure your calculator is always in radians. So when you're checking sine inverse of 1 over 2, it's pi over 6. So pi over 6 times 1 over 6 is pi over 36, plus this would be 36 minus 9, which is 25 over 36, square root of 35 over 26. This is 1 over 2 square root of 3. This part you can check with the calculator, minus 1 over 3. Or you can write this in terms of decimal places. Can use a calculator, just write the value, right? And then you're done. This is your value of this integral. So when you have indefinite integrals, it means your final answer should be a number, right? Okay. let me please try this one. I did give them a solution in class integrate. X times sine of x squared dx. Okay, integrate this function. Did give them the example, this as an example in class, but I want you to try as an exercise again. Okay. Take it down. All right. Now, let me give you another example. Let's say we want to integrate e to the 3x times sine x dx. Again, we want to integrate the product of two functions, e to the 3x times sine x dx. So obviously, we're going to use integration by parts. But the main thing of me doing this example, I want to show you that you can sometimes use integration by parts twice. So, okay. We're gonna see in this example. Again, we want to integrate the product. Use integration by parts. Integration by parts formula, integral of u dv equal to uv minus integral of v du. Yeah? Okay. Let's checking something here. We want to integrate this using integration by parts, using this name lead. We have a trig and exponential function. Eh? But if you have trig and exponential function, no matter what you choose, u or dv, it's always going to be you find a correct answer. Eh? But just to follow the order, let's just use this method. Trig comes first before exponential. Eh? So I'll let u equal to my trig function, which is sine x. Eh? And then my du, dv, choose u and dv. Eh? My u, my trig function, because comes first, and then exponential function will be dv. Eh? It's e to the 3x. Dv always go with dx. Eh? And next, from u, find du. Du is derivative of this, which is cos x with dx. And then from dv, find v. Integral of this is e to the 3x over 3. This is match 1, integral of e to the 3x, eh? E to the 3x over 3, yeah? So the derivative of the inner function is a constant, and just integrating e is e to the 3x, and then divided by this derivative of the inner function, only if it's a constant, okay? So now you're ready to use this formula to integrate your function. I want to integrate e to the 3x sine x dx. Since we said this is u and this is dv, it's follow now this formula of integration by parts. I always write uv minus integration of v du. Right? And then the next step is just substitute everything into my formula. Okay. So this will be uv, u times v. So this is just the sine of x times e to the 3x over 3, né? Minus integral of v e to the 3x over 3. Let me put constant as I always put out constant. Then. This is v, yeah? I'm substituting v, v is e to the 3x over 3, yeah? But I pull out this 3. And then times du, this is du. My du is cos x dx. You see, now I want to integrate the second term again. It's also looks I'm integrating the product of two functions. I don't have a standard form from this one or any standard form of integrating this except integration by parts because I'm integrating the product. So I'll have to repeat integration by parts for the second term. Okay. So, right. So let's do integration by parts for the second term. Yeah. So for the second term, in the integration by parts, we need to choose what is u and what is dv. Yeah? And then again, 3 comes first before the in this name Elliot, 3 comes first before exponential. Eh? So u will be a trick. So u will be, I'm sorry about this, and space. So u would be a metric function cos of x, and then dv would be my exponential function. Which is e to the 3x, but go with the x, eh? And then from u find du, which is minus sine x, eh? But always do you go with the x. The derivative of sine x, cos x is minus sine x. But do you go with the x? And then from dv find v, v again is e to the 3x over 3. Né? Okay. So now this is u and this is dv. It now follow integration by parts formula. You know integration by parts, this will be equal to uv minus integral of v du. Eh? So instead of this, I'll substitute everything here in my formula for this second part because I'm integrating using this formula, integration by parts formula. Okay. So what I'll do here. So this integral, let's say for now, it's using integration by parts. Integral of e to the 3x times sine x dx. I use integration by parts. But meaning for the second term, it requires integration by parts for this one. And then I choose u and du and dv. And then I need to substitute into my formula, right? So for this integral, I'll substitute integral by parts u times v. Check for this part. I find u, I said u will be trig, which is cos, and v is e to the 3x over 3. Yeah? So u times v, the first term, u times v. So it should be e to the 3x times cos x over 3. When I multiply u times v, yeah? The first term, minus integral of v, if I check v, this is e oder 3x over 3. Jetzt wir put over 3 hier, sind die constant. And it's multiplied by du. Du. You see my du is minus sign x dx. So that minus will make this positive sign x dx. You see now what we did here. The figure. Safono integrator length of value is the funo integrator. Now this is the first question there is supposed to be another person. They said evaluate this integral, okay? From the question. So we notice we need to use integration by parts. Okay. For this one, we use integration by parts. We let u to be sine of x and then dv and then find du and v. Yeah? And tells us everything to the formula. So what we notice in our second term when we're trying to evaluate the integral of the second term, we notice what's from our 7 is of course integration by parts again. Eh? That's why here we're choosing u and dv for the second term, eh? And then we substituted everything into our integration by parts formula here. And then again, you see when we simplify this. Our integral e to the 3x sine x dx will be sine x times e to the 3x over 3 minus 1 over 9 e to the 3x cos x and then multiply to the first term. To the second term, it's going to be minus 1 over 9 integral of e to the 3x times sine x dx. So you notice again for the last term we need to evaluate this and it need integration by parts again. So what I'm saying to you right now, I can only want you to do integration by parts at least twice, at most twice. Eh? So for the third time, always check if this integral it not look like something that's off thing. Okay. You see, from a challenge, the integral of e to the 3x sine of x dx, so it's all like, so if so bona gonna learn the lay a quinine for now, you're gonna let it to be I. We let I to be this integral of it. We can't use the integration by part for the third time, eh? But you notice it's something that looks like something that's failing a for now, which is integral of e to the 3x sine of x dx. And then mustn't consider from my last step, I'll just gonna solve for I. I'll substitute I and solve for I. I did integral failing a for now and it's from the start. Okay. So let's do that. Yeah. So this is, you see, this is I, yeah? I equal to sine x e to the 3x over 3 minus 1 over 9 e to the 3x times cos x minus 1 over 9. See, this is also I, yeah? This one was I, the NSFILR, I. So the solve for I, take I to the right hand side, so it should be I plus 1 over 9I, which give us 10 over 9I equal to sine x e to the 3x over 3. Minus 1 over 9 e to the 3x cos x. So what is I? Lass uns so sein. I ist das Integral, was das letzte Mal ist hier. You see now I will be 9, we just multiply by 9 over 10 on both sides. 9 over 10, we can start with e to the 3x times sine x over 3 minus 1 over 9 e to the 3x cos x. And remember, I, which was the integral that you want to evaluate, I is this integral. So let's substitute it back. So I is just our integral. So instead of I, we just gonna write our integral, which is e to the 3x sine of x dx okay, on the left hand side, which will be equal to 9 over 10 e to the 3x sine of x over 3 minus 1 over 9 e to the 3x times cos of x and then it just say plus c. Okay. All right. This is the answer, right? Okay. I can try this. Integrate. The cos of ln 2x dx. Try this integral. Cos of ln 2x. Just to give you a hint, I'm not doing a solution. Hint. Always when you integrating cos of a log function, we use integration by parts. We using integration by parts. You write the formula down. Integral of u dv equal to u v minus integral of v du. That's your first step. Second step, you need to choose what is u and what is dv. U is always going to be that trick of a log function. So in this case, you can add that u equal to cos of ln 2x. And then dv would be the rest, which is just dx. So deriving du here. Yeah. When you're deriving du, du is just going to be minus sine of ln 2x over x dx. Check if you derive cos of ln 2x to get this. And then from dv, find v, it's going to be x. And then substitute everything into your formula when you evaluate this, because now this is u and dv. Let's follow this integration by parts. Okay. What you notice here in the second term, you need to use the integration by parts because you will see a trick of log again, which will be sine of ln 2x that come from here in the second term from du when you substitute du in the second term. So it we need you to do again integration by parts for the second time. but don't allow it to do integration for the third time. And then for the third time, when you see that you need integration by parts, check if it that is not what look like something that you already been asked a challenge. You'll find that it's cost of lean 2x. So you let that integral equal to I and just solve for I. And that will be your integral at the end. And then you just say plus C as you did in this last example. But I want you to try that again. Try this. And also, this is the hint. Okay. I'll give you more exercise. I'll send it to ClassRep, okay? Thank you.